So it's about to be a humongous month for the Bleach anime in terms of news and just merchandise and anything else in between, because after all, this video is about to give you the release date for the Bleach anime. So stick around. So as of today, an official source, not really a leak, had dropped, but unfortunately this tweet did in fact get deleted, to which I had already saved it before it did get deleted. And as you see on the screen, this is the person who made, as well as Kudo, one of the key visuals for Bleach, as well as the Stone Ritter one versus like the Soul Reaper one that you've seen as well on the website. For one of the reasons of why this was deleted, I do not know. I imagine it was probably premature and probably posted the wrong image of which they meant to have posted. We don't quite know which is which, but however, this is official and this is the actual key visual with the date on it being the 10th of October 2022. Now, personally, I would have preferred a much later date within October, because again, the more time, the more staff has to, you know, touch upon things. But regardless of what, I've heard production has been going well and a little bit better as of recently. Of course, there's been some issues with an episode here or there, but again, things have been cleaned up a little bit more, so hopefully we are on the right track again. So fingers crossed on that. As well as the date, you will actually also see the time of which Bleach will be airing as well. We don't really have a TV station as of yet, but I would imagine it's TV Tokyo. Actually, in fact, it is TV Tokyo if I'm aware. But regardless of what, at 12 o'clock midnight for Japan on Monday going into Tuesday, that's when the Bleach Thousand Year War will be streaming or airing. Because, in fact, that is what we expected, as I did a video on this over a year ago explaining that it will have a late night time slot because of having no censorship. Again, it's called the Thousand Year Blood War arc. It is very hard to censor, even if you wanted to, unless, again, you did some Seven Deadly Sins. We won't talk about that. And yeah, I'm very happy about that. I know people had some grievances about whether the Thousand Year Blood War was going to be censored or not. Of course, if anything, I hope this confirms what was already confirmed in the first place. The other question would be, would it be censored on streaming platforms? And again, no, that's not going to be happening. I can't stress that enough, because I still get that question to this day. So yeah, depending on wherever you are in the world, chances are this is going to be streaming around about the evening time or the afternoon time, so it's a good round time for everyone to enjoy it. Now granted, this will be on a Monday going into Tuesday, as I said. Preferably, I would have preferred a weekend, because again, that's where more viewers are going to be, rather than on a work day or a school night, as some might call it. So, you know, again, I take it how it is. I still think it's going to do successful nonetheless, because again, Chainsaw Man is also going to be on Tuesday as well. So yeah, interesting time slot, interesting days to choose. So again, I have no qualms with it. It makes sense. I'm glad that it's on at a midnight time. But if you also look at the poster in and of itself, at the very bottom of the poster, you will see the official confirmations of the openings and the endings. Now, of course, I'm not familiar with the person that is doing the ending song, the artist being called Senna Rin. If you want to go check her out, she's done some good songs. I've only heard of one so far. Apparently she's up and coming, so again, if anyone wants to correct me in the comments section down below, I do applaud you too, as well as liking and subscribing to keep up to date with all the Bleach news. But of course, we have a reoccurring artist coming on for the opening. Some of you may know him as Tetsuya Kitani, who did the Bleach Expo song for the Bleach Expo, to which I was surprised that they actually chose Kitani, because even though I've listened to his songs, maybe not enough of them, I'm not quite sure, but from the samples and the songs that I've heard, even the anime openings that he's done in the past, I don't really get a Blood War feel. Because when I think of the Thousand Year Blood War, I feel like it should be like kind of grungy, kind of hardcore metal-y, and I would say Kitani hits more around about the pop rock or maybe hard rock. I'm not quite sure where really to fit him in. I'm not a music expert in any means. I hear what I hear and I like what I like. But does he really fit the Thousand Year Blood War arc? Well, if Kubo is happy with it, Kubo is happy with it. He's the one that chose it after all. So I've got high hopes and I'm putting my faith in both of them in this sort of situation. Now, if you were to ask me what I would have expected or what I would have preferred, maybe I would have gone for Sim. They did an amazing job with Bleach opening 13, but that's because I can envision it and compare it, whereas I can't with Kitani. So again, I'm excited to be impressed. I'm excited to go into it not knowing what to expect. So yeah, what are your guys' thoughts on Kitani? Because again, the Bleach Expo music did hit hard. So there you have it. You have the opening and the official broadcast date. What do you guys think about it? Are you excited? Of course you are. When can we expect to hear these things, and when can we expect to get an official broadcast date, if you want to call it official? being through a PV2 or PV3, whichever you want to call it. Even though I kind of classify the pre-animated trailer as PV1, some people might not. So when is PV2 or PV3 coming? Well, I would imagine probably a week or two before the actual series actually begins to air. So I imagine because we have two expositions coming right up, which is, you know, Disney 23, which is probably where we're going to get the announcement in a few days in regards to whether Disney have acquired the rights to Bleach, whether they'll announce it at the expo or whether they'll just announce it on their Twitter page. And if they don't, that's just going to get really confusing. Like, and I mean really confusing. Like, I'm pretty positive from what I've heard and from what I know, and I trust who I trust. You know, there's always that sense of doubt, and I have to always be like 99% about things. So if they don't, because again, I don't know. I don't really know Disney like that. I don't really know how they operate. Then we have to wait until New York Comic Con, which is on the 8th of October. So quite a while away. Actually, tell a lie, we actually have Aniplex Festa as well, which is, again, towards the end of the month, which I believe might be on the 23rd. Again, don't quote me on that. I can't remember. I'm going off the top of my dome. Which I know for a fact Aniplex will definitely have a PV. Like, it's not even a question. It will definitely have a PV for Bleach. So we're going to get the opening involved in that. Whether we're going to get the ending, I don't know. Maybe they'll do two PVs. Nothing's out the question. I'm kind of basing it off of what PVs I've seen in the past. But I'm excited to see what kind of PV they're going to show. Because usually with the last PV, they always show the opening song with that. So don't worry about Disney. Don't worry about Viz's New York Comic Con. Let's focus on Aniplex because we know we're going to get some really cool stuff. And hopefully we'll get an episode count as well. Or maybe a placeholder. I don't really know what else they can announce. But nonetheless, I'm excited for that as a whole. And I guess while we're on the topic of talking about, you know, streaming services and licenses, as I said, most of my sources personally come from the European side. I don't know about America. Usually they have a conjunction with each other. If Europe has something, chances are 99% of the time, North America has exactly the same thing, and it doesn't make sense to simulcast in one region but not the other, especially with how big Europe is. But if we have a situation where it is North American and, you know, Viz do stream Bleach, you know, in North America and they don't for Europe, then technically I'm not wrong. But also the whole Disney thing is weird too, because they're not known for doing simulcasts as well, other than like their Marvel shows or their original shows. So it's a bit convoluted. And honestly, I'm just waiting to see where things pan out and just seeing where things may have gone right and where things may have gone wrong. So hopefully I'll try and update you on that as soon as possible. And if we get an announcement from Disney, at least we'll be a little bit more closer to understanding what the context and situation is. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed getting the news about the broadcast finally, and also the openings of which we're going to get. Is Kitani going to do a banger? Who knows? That is the question. And look forward to the PV and probably much more news coming within this month. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.